Good is it for a man to gain the whole world yet forfeit his own soul?
That's right. That's right.
What can a man give in exchange for his soul?
That's right.
If anyone is ashamed of me and my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, the Son of Man will be ashamed of him. And what God said to me is that when you're not willing to live this life, you're ashamed of him.
That's right.
You're showing that you're ashamed.
Wow.
And when he comes, he's going to be ashamed of you.
That's right. That's right.
Because you didn't live worthy of his death.
Yeah.
You didn't live worthy of his death. Praise God.
That's right, amen.
Praise God. Praise God. Let's thank the Lord.
Amen.
Let's
amen.
Praise him right now. Let's praise him right now. In Matthew 10, it says, anyone who does not take his cross and follow me is not worthy of me. It's not worthy of me. Do we have a puny Christian? Christianity and a powerful Christ? No, we have a powerful Christ and a powerful Christianity. Amen?
Right.
Amen. Anyone who does not love me more than their mother, their father, their son, their daughter is not worthy of me.
That's right.
Whoever finds his life will lose it. Whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. See, people are looking for something real. Amen?
Amen.
People really are. A young man told me, we younger generation, we want it raw. We want it raw, he said to me. We want the raw and rugged. Guitar center. So we want, praise God. Tired of the phony.
Amen.
Tired of the cheap grace. Come on. Come on.
Amen.
If it's worth him dying for, it's worth us giving up everything for.
Amen.
It's worth us giving up everything for. Praise God.
Amen.
And young people love it, Miss Brandy. Young people love. Deep down. They might be spoiled by American Christianity. But deep down their hearts desire.
Yeah.
That's right.
They want it real.
Yeah.
They want it real. Praise God. To those who by persistence and doing good, come on. Obedience.
Yeah.
Obedience.
Amen.
Seek. What am I seeking by my law? I'm seeking glory. I'm seeking to be changed. To have a glorified state. To not be like this in this body forever. Guys, when we die and we come forth, we receive a new body. And it's called the state of glory. It's being glorified. Come on, y'all.
That's right. That's right.
And honor and immortality. Guys, honor. Honor is God created us as above all other creatures. We are God's highest creation.
Amen.
And if we don't reach the glorified state, it dishonors us. Because the only alternative is horrible. And I'm sharing that just a second. But we're seeking glory. We're seeking honor. Being honored by God. Amen.
Amen.
And immortality. That we will live forever. I'm seeking it. Are you seeking it? Are you seeking immortality? Amen.
Yes.
Amen. I was on the plane with a man. My husband was there and all of a bunch of people. And this man was, I was talking to him. And he said he didn't believe in God. He said, but I can't stand the thought of being annihilated. Me and my wife and my five kids. I can't stand not existing anymore. I said, no, you will exist forever. Whether you are with God or whether you are with the enemy. You will exist forever.
That's right.
But the state in hell is not called immortality. Immortality is a glorious thing.
Right.
It's life to the full. Amen?
Yes.
And so it says down below in verse 10, it says, but what we have to look forward to is glory. What we have to look, verse 10, what we have to look forward to is glory. Glory. The glorified state, being in the presence of God forever, and honor and peace for everyone who does right. Not on your own, not by your own works. Come on, help me, guys.
Right now.
Not by your own ability to do good.
No, right.
No works will get us to heaven except those who flow from Christ in us.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
And peace for everyone. First for the Jew, then for the Gentile. For God does not show favoritism. Please, please listen. Please, the peace it's talking about is that there is no more pangs to the conscience.
Amen.
Come on, y'all.
Amen.
There's no regrets. Help me.
Amen.
No regrets.
Amen.
Come on. There's no worry.
Yeah.
There's not a single worry. Amen. There's not a single
right.
fear.
Right.
There's not a speck. There's not a speck of guilt or shame. There's nothing but peace.
Amen.
Peace.
Right.
Peace. Praise God.
Amen.
The absence of all of that distress.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
But
yes.
Those, verse 8, who yes. are self-seeking and who reject the truth and follow evil, there
yes.
will be wrath and anger.
Yes.
There will
yes.
be trouble and distress. Listen.
Yes. Yes.
Distress.
Yes.
Opposite of peace. Distress.
God.
for every human being who does evil.
Yes.
God has wrath against sin. And we store it up every day that we rebel. Every day that we fail to come clean with God.
Yeah.
Come on. We've gone back to our sin. We better get back.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
If you've not come to Christ before, come. Come while the door's open.
Yeah.
Amen.
Come while there's time.
Amen.
Come while there's grace.
Yes.
The day of grace will be over.
That's right. That's right.
Those who are not ready for the judgment, they will live forever with a tortured conscience, with no relief. I want you to think about every sin you've ever committed weighing down on you for all eternity. When you think about the distress of having all your sin, there's no way you can escape from it. See, I'm telling you, the wrath stored up means that all the stuff you add day by day is going to be added to your load in hell forever. Your conscience already burdened today by all you've already done. And then all that you do forever, you're storing up wrath against yourself. Nobody but yourself. Nobody else can take it from you.
No, no.
There is no God to pray to in hell. Guys, there is no spirit. There is no peace. There is no help. There is nothing for you there. It's all on you. You have to bear it for all eternity. Oh, God. You'll be given a body. There's something really weird about your body. You're going to get a body. It says you're going to, I'm going to read it to you, Daniel 12. Multitudes who sleep in the dust of the earth will awake, some to everlasting life, others to shame and everlasting contempt. Those who are wise will shine like the brightness of the heavens.
Yes.
And those who lead many to righteousness like the stars. You see, by your life, you're either winning people to Christ or you're keeping people from Christ.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
If you're wise, if you wise up, come on.
That's right.
If you wise up, you can get on the other side.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
You can get under the blessing of eternal life. Praise God. You're going to have a body. Your body's going to be weird. He says you'll be raised to shame and contempt. There's going to be some kind of a deformity. You're going to be a spectacle. There's going to be something really weird about the body of the unsaved. But it will live forever. Those that are in heaven, there will be no pain. But those in hell will have constant, everlasting pain. We have the pain from the conscience and all the weight of all the shame and all the sin.
Yes.
But against your body, you will have fire that burns nonstop.
Right.
Burns your body and yet does not burn it up. Because you cannot die. You will be eaten by maggots, the Bible says. So you'll become more and more and more deformed, and yet you can't die. And you will be treated terribly by demons and the devil. There's absolutely no way humans can explain other than the few words in the Bible. But I believe every word of it.
Yes.
Yes, that's right.
I believe every word of it. Amen. See, the biggest mistake sinners make is they have a life that's about this long. And they use it for pleasure. They use it for themselves. They use it to do what they want. But it lasts about that long before you die.
That's right. That's right.
And then you have this long forever and ever and ever and ever in punishment for what you got this much pleasure on. That's for you. unconscionable that you would do that to yourself. That you would treasure pleasure more than the pearl of great price. More than God in your life. You would treasure that little bit of stuff the world gives. Come on. The little bit of pleasure from sin. You choose that over forever and ever, suffering and torture and pain.